it's on now.
Baton Rouge, it's official. National recording artist Webby and the Savage Squad have teamed up with the hottest clothing line in BR. Authentic BR 225 gear, aka Jake City Clothing. The gear is hot, it's fresh, it's what's up. You have many styles to choose from. Tall tees, short and long sleeve. Authentic fitted baseball caps and embroidered polo style shirts with the BR logo. You can be officially repped out in BR 225 gear. So rep your hood. That's BR 225 gear. Get you some. Oops, I almost forgot. Bootleg this.
Welcome back. Leading 14-0 at the half and going against a team that averages nearly 40 points a game, Greg, you could almost feel the anticipation in the Superdome. People knew it would be just a matter of time before Grambling would post some points on the board.
Oh, absolutely, Clarence. Everybody knew that Grambling was going to score. The question was, could Southern match them point for point? And the third quarter, one of the best we've seen all season. 29 points combined for by the two teams. It was just great second half football action.
And exactly as you said, Greg, it did not take long for the Grambling Tigers to put those points on the board. Let's go to second half highlights.
Down by two touchdowns at the half, the Grambling Tigers received their wake-up call in the locker room. Norman Bradford taking the opening kickoff for the second half and going 85 yards for the touchdown. Gilad Landau's PAT was true, and the Jaguars led by 7, 14-7. The Jaguars weren't through just yet, however. One possession later, Eric Randall turns the tide, going in for 11 yards and the touch. Northern's PAT was true, and the Jags were back up by 14, 21-7. After a Gilad Landau 34-yard field goal made the score 21-10, the Tigers then went after yet another touchdown. This is Eric Gant, fourth and goal. He's in for the touch. The PAT was no good, and the Jaguars then led 21-16. On to fourth quarter action. Dexter Butcher, with a gain of 12, sets up the Tigers first and goal from the one. From there, it's the big fullback, Eric Gant, the one-yard plunge for the touchdown. The PAT was true, and the Tigers assumed their first lead of the game, 23-21. On the ensuing possession, the Jaguars said, no, this thing isn't over just yet. Eric Randall teams up with Cornell Johnson. Johnson carries for the touchdown. The PAT was no good, and it stood 27-23 Jaguars. In the waning moments of the fourth, the Tigers would come back to notch what would be the game winner. Alex Perkins, the senior, goes in all alone for the touchdown. The PAT was true. Our final, 30-27 Grambling in Bayou Classic 19.
Once again, the final in Bayou Classic 19, the Tigers of Grambling 30, the Jaguars of Southern 27. You know, Greg, it's an often overused adage among sportscasters that in this particular game, there were no winners, there were no losers. But you certainly have to think that that particular saying has precedence in this game.
Well, I'll tell you what, both of these teams played great football on Saturday night, Clarence. Exciting football. When Southern looks back at this game, they'll look back at two moments. They block a punt in the third quarter. They're out in front. They could have extended their lead. Instead, they don't score anything. Grambling comes back and takes the lead. Last Grambling drive, controversial pass interference call, very close call, could have gone either way. It went Grambling's favor. They capitalize, get in for the winning touchdown. That is a play that they will talk about in this series for a long time to come.
A long time to come, Greg. Stay with us. There is more Jaguar spirit on this special Bayou Classic edition.
Are you paying
to the defensive side of the football? But that's the case, as Sean Wallace is the MVP of Bayou Classic 19.
This Bayou Classic Player of the Week segment is brought to you by Big Al's Appliances and Electronics, a proud supporter of Jaguar Spirit Football.
Sean, give me a reaction to being named MVP of the contest.
Well, I kind of got mixed reactions. It's a great honor, but at the time, I would like to have been on the winning side. I can't really enjoy it like I knew I would if we won. But I guess I got to be happy. You know, it's a great honor.
Playing this game before in your hometown, before your fans and your folks, obviously that had to pump you up even a little bit more than it's just being Grambling today.
Yeah, I wanted to show the home folks that I can go out and show them a good showing. You know, I wanted to play hard, but most important, I just wanted to win. If that meant me playing terrible and me winning, I would rather have that.
Player of the Week has been brought to you by Big Al's Appliances and Electronics.
The Jaguars and Tigers weren't the only SWAC teams in action this weekend. Alcorn State's Braves took on the Indians of Northeast in the first round of the 1AA playoffs.
The Bayou Classic SWAC scoreboard is brought to you by Varsity Cleaners, a proud supporter of Jaguar Spirit Football. Dressed always and for weekly discounts, see the cleaning professionals at Varsity Cleaners.
Number 19, but Clarence, as we reiterated throughout the show, this is just a great ball game, one the fans surely enjoyed, one I know I enjoyed watching.
And certainly the same holds true for me, Greg. An important thing that I think we should mention here is the fact that both schools just signed a 10-year contract with the city of New Orleans for the Bayou Classic, and a game of this magnitude and this type of intensity could not have come at a better time.
It sure could not have. NBC loved it. The fans across the nation had a great show to watch. And all I can say is I can't wait until next year and that last weekend in November when the Jags and Tigers will do it again at the Louisiana Superdome with Bayou Classic 20. We've enjoyed bringing you this show. We hope that you enjoyed watching it. And we hope that, Clarence, you'll be with me again next year when we do this 365 days later for Bayou Classic 20. For Clarence Buggs, I'm Greg Burchell. See you next year.
For a videotaped copy of today's program or any episode of the Jaguar Spirit Show, send a $20 check or money order to 2 Plus 2 Productions, 385 South 11th Street, Suite 8, Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 70802. Or charge it by calling 1-800-673-1522. Please specify the date of the show you wish to receive and allow 3 to 4 weeks delivery.